I was a DoD contractor. We flew Learjets for the Department of Defense, and we actually were basically a training operation for the Strategic Air Force folks with 1st Air Force. We had a manager that was the site manager for the site that we were at, and he actually started doing some things that everybody was really getting sort of ticked off at. Somebody found a notebook that he had where he had written down everything somebody, his people did that he didn't like, dates, times, da 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 da. And the problem is one of his people found the notebook one time. And you can tell the motivation, the spirit, the trust dropped like an anchor. Somehow headquarters found out about it. And I actually got a call from the director at my home one day. And he simply said, Randy, I know you don't have any axes to grind. Would you be willing to talk to me? And I said, sure. We had about a 20-minute conversation. He asked me, he said, well, what do you think is necessary down there? And here's what I told him. He said, the first thing that is needed down there is that people need to be able to trust that anything they say in the confines of our offices, as long as there's no clients there, there's no military personnel there or anything like that, that they can say anything they want and they'll never hear about it again. And the director asked me, he said, that's an interesting and a different approach. I said, I know it is. And he asked me, he said, why do you say that? And I said, for two reasons. He said, first and foremost, if these folks think that they need to vent a little bit, I want them doing it in the living room of our offices and not at 35,000 feet where there's a safety issue. He said, well, that's a pretty good point. I said, I kind of thought so. I said, the second reason is simply this. If I'm going to lead these people, I have to know what they're really experiencing, believing, and sensing with the bark on. And I have to be willing to listen to it. Not saying I can always do anything about it, but I got to listen to it. And he said, why is that? And I said, because if I'm going to lead these people, I need to hear it. And I need to know that. About a week later, I was promoted to take over that position. What were the results of the different philosophy that I brought to the team? Very interesting that 6 months later, and by the way, some of the folks tested me on it once or twice to see if I was serious about it, and they found out the truth. But about 6 months later, I was lauded in writing by the executive leadership, and they said, quote, Randy took a problem site and turned it around into the showcase of the company in minimum time. If people learn to lead people rather than just pushing on them and dictating and mandating on them, it can make a huge difference. And when you're talking about leading teams in a changing environments where sometimes emotions can be there, sometimes fears can be there, sometimes stress can be there, and that can engender different things. But knowing how to lead that and giving people the ability to have trust and get beyond that is key when you're talking about a changing environment. All of us have more potential than we're currently using. Our vision at Coaching for Relevance is to bring freedom to potential in all those across my path. So I want to just challenge you to go check out our organizational maneuverability course and see how that can provide you insights that maybe that you're not seeing right now. And I also want to invite you to give us a call if you'd like to have a conversation about some items. So we want to just leave that with you, and thank you for your time.